Greetings, everybody, and welcome to Let's Play 7 Days to Die Alpha 15 with Zombies Always Running, episode number 69. Let's not have any rude puns about that one. Right, so we are back at the base, and I pretty much gone and got most of the stuff from the hub city, or as much of it as I could back in one run. There's still some stuff over there, but I've, you know, left some stuff there just in case you want to go back and get it a bit later on. Now, what I want to do is... I think I want to do some improvements to this castle over here. And there's a few things that I'd like to do to it in particular. One thing I'd like to do is to, of course, make the walls a little bit better. Because in the last horde fight, spiders just literally got inside. And it didn't go well. Because they got straight in and they pretty much nearly killed me, which is not good. However, I've had a suggestion from a guy who commented on episode 62. It's Sir Splintfast the Pungent. And he said look on a channel called Shadiversity. And this guy does pretty much everything to do with castles. He is the castle guru, this guy, Shadiversity. And he was just like, check out Shadiversity's channel and use that as inspiration for the castle that you've got. So while we've got some of the things that make the castle kind of castly, and I just realized that block is missing there, I'll have to replace that. While we've got some of the things that kind of make it castly, there are a few other things that we can do. Especially in improving this wall, which is something that I want to get into pretty quickly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump into Creative World and I'm going to show you some ideas that I've got. And let's see how well they work before I get on improving these things. Because I want to expand the castle as well. I want to replace this building with like a main keep as well. So there's plenty of stuff that I want to do with it. I'm going to get a lot of resources to do that though. So let me just jump into Creative World and I can walk you through a few things and see if they work with the blocks. Now I know that flagstone only has 3 shapes, so we're going to have to come up with something with the flagstone to allow us to, you know, come up with the design that we want to use. But let's have a look and see what we can do. Alrighty guys, we are now in the creative world and I've pretty much gone and done a mock-up of what the wall is that we have right now. So you can see that I've pretty much got this as my wall. All it is a very simple walkway with, you know, some arrow slits and some things either side. Now, there are 2 problems with this. One thing is it's a bit difficult to see lower down. The other problem is a spider can actually get straight up this thing. So if we come down here, you can see it's just flat. The spiders can get straight up. Even with the little nooks that we made in the wall and the windows, the spiders can still get in. Plus, they can get in the windows as well, so they have the opportunity to get into the castle. Now, what I've gone and done is taken some inspiration, and I've now made a design a little bit like this. And these parts of the wall now, as you can see, are taller. This will provide me cover from a cop's bit a little bit. And then you can also see that I've done this. Now, what I've done is I've lowered this with a flagstone ramp. I've used a cobblestone pillar 50 because it doesn't look too out of place with the flagstone there. And then I've used an arrow slit. And then what these things are called, apparently, is a machicolation. And this is what you can use to then come off to the side like this and see straight down the wall, which is something that we couldn't do very easily before. But now we can. So this kind of design is going to allow us to very, very easily see what's down the side of the wall when the zombies get too close, which they definitely are going to get too close. And the good thing is this cobblestone pillar 50 will prevent me falling over the edge. Plus, I get the protection of an arrow slit right here if I need one. So these little machicolations are pretty awesome, actually. And from the outside, it looks pretty damn cool. I've used like the flagstone stairs upside down there, and it kind of meshes in with the cobblestone. You don't notice too much that that's cobblestone, which I think is pretty nice. And I might actually consider making those out of cobblestone as well, considering that that's the bit I'm going to be standing up, and that's where cops are going to be puking at me mainly. So yeah, this is our old wall. And this is our new wall that I'm planning on building. Now, another thing I'm probably even needing to do as well is to get rid of all the windows on the outside. Because although they look cool, you can't really see exactly what's in there. So a castle wall really wouldn't have any windows on the outside. It would literally just be like this. Because, you know, obviously castle walls are meant to defend you and not allow anyone to get through them. So by having windows in there instead, that's going to allow us to by taking out the windows, that's going to allow us to have more opportunity to stop spiders from getting in there. So I think the second design actually works quite well. Let me quickly make it out of cobblestone and we'll see if it looks any better or whether we should keep it as flagstone, because I quite like the look of that, but maybe cobblestone will give it a bit of artistic flair as well. So let's just have a quick try and I'll be right back. Alrighty, here is the cobblestone variant, and I actually kind of like it. It looks a bit different. It doesn't quite mesh in as well with the wall, but it gives it a nice bit of difference on the top. So it looks different, but I still quite like it. So this will provide better defense if I want that. And I think that's what I'm going to go for. I think the cobblestone one is going to be fine, because obviously better defense from cop puke is what I need to be aware of. So yeah, that's going to be very cool. And then I can still aim down here and see back to the, I can even see back to the wall from this standing point right here as well, which is really good. So I can actually see there and here simultaneously, which is pretty neat. So I think that's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be doing a cobblestone variant of this. So I'll have to obviously go and make some frames and some stair frames and stuff like that. But yeah, I think this is the project I want to work on for this episode, just to get these up and together. And then, of course, to fill in all the windows in the castle to stop those damn spiders from getting inside. So yeah, we need something that's going to be a bit better. So this is what I'm going to work on today, I think. So let me go ahead and pop back into my normal world, go mine some resources, and then I'll be right back once I've made everything and we can actually start putting this thing together. And then we can see how it looks in the end. Now, the towers, of course, are going to be a bit of a different story. I'm going to have to try and work out something for the towers as well. I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do with those at the moment, but yeah, I'm going to have a look-see and see if I can figure something out for those, because it's, as you know, it's a pretty difficult job building it with blocks, but yeah, it's workable, and I've definitely shown with this that it can work, and we can see everything down on the wall, especially when we crouch like that, we can see straight down like that. That is perfect. So that's definitely something I'm going to want to use. So I'll be right back, and then we can start building this thing once I've collected all the resources and stuff. Chunk bug! All right, many, many hours later, I think I've finally got all the resources that I need together. Now, I have the workbench crafting up a crap ton of cobblestone, as you can see, because I'm going to need more anyway to expand the castle out some more when I want to. And yeah, I think we are ready to go. Now, we are going to use, of course, the fancy nail gun for doing all our upgrades and things. So I've gone ahead as well and taken out the... I'll come and show you. Hang on, I can actually go this way. Why am I going that way? I can go through the door in the Happy Balloon Blacksmith and get to the top. And I need to upgrade those doors as well. I have not done that, so there's a thing I need to do soon. Right, so I'll show you guys what I've done so far. I've literally just gone ahead and taken out all of these bits on the top in preparation for doing this stuff. So the first thing we need to do is, I believe, lay down these things first. So these are going to still be flagstone, because they're a lot cheaper to make, and they're going to be, you know, what I'm kind of looking down. Now, unfortunately, this is an even number of width, so I'm going to have to make that one too wide, but that's okay. So that's, is there a piece of destroyed stone right there still? There is! Let me just go and check for any more. Yeah, sometimes there's like little bits of destroyed stone left. Okay, hang on. Let me try and get this to go the way that I want it to. I want it to go that way. There we go. So yeah, it's usually quicker doing that than trying to cycle through the full rotations. But there we go. So we're going to lay these down first. So I'm going to go and do the sides that need them. Now, I'm not sure really what we can do about the top of the towers. I want it to be the same kind of design, but where it's like hexagonal, I don't know if it's going to work. So we might have to end up squaring off the towers at the top, at least, to make it work, which I don't mind doing. I think that might look kind of interesting. So we can try that. Let's try and put these down and not fall to our death as well. That's another thing that we got to be mindful of. Right, so next ones are going this way. So, oh, I could have done that wall just there, couldn't I, really? Oh, well, let's do this one. So we can... Oh, there is another piece of destroy stone there. Get out of here. I thought I got rid of all these. Oh, well. It happens. Right, let's go from here. So yeah, for this bit, again, I'm not sure if we can keep the same design going all the way around, but we're definitely going to have to take that spike out to make it more consistent as well. So yeah, the corners are going to be a little bit more tricky to get right, I think. So it's going to be fine, though. So once you've done this bit, we'll be halfway done. So let's go and do this side of the wall. There we go, just trying not to misplace them and waste too much time, because I spent so much time resource gathering. I've literally went around the entire area and pretty much got every single small and big rock as far as the eye can see. There's one like over there, but there's like a lot of the rocks around here that have been taken out. I can see a few over there, but all those are gone. There were loads over here. I took all those out as well, because they give you rocks so much quicker than the actual stone, which is really odd. And I don't know quite how that works, considering those rocks are smaller than the stone blocks themselves, but oh well. Right, let's go ahead and lay these down. Now, one thing I haven't seen in a while is a screamer, so I'm kind of glad about that. And to be honest, building something like this doesn't attract screamers, really. I know if you build a lot, you can attract a screamer, but that's literally if you put a ton of blocks down, like over, but I think you have to place, like, about 1,000 blocks down or so before you actually summon a screamer. But I know if you build a lot that you can. Oh god damn it, there's get out of here, you silly block. Right, here we go, and then there should be just the one side to I swear I took these out. Probably just missed them having a blind moment. Right, there we go. And what's up with my guy? He's hot. Okay. Oh, and I placed that the wrong way too. Yay! Okay, let's just get rid of that one. Now, I did accidentally hit out some of the blocks around here, so I'm going to have to go and repair them. But that's alright. Okay, here we go. So yeah, this is how it's going to work. So yeah, allowing me to shoot straight down is something that's going to be very, very necessary. Because we struggled to get the zombies outside previously, so we're going to need something to shoot down when they're at the walls. So there's that one, and let's go to the other side and do exactly the same thing, and then we can get the stairs and the you can get the stairs and the parapets in. Yeah, weird word that is, actually. Machicolation. I always forget what it is, and I have to keep re-looking up the word. And it's only like, you know, it's only been like 20 minutes since I said it last, you know. It's just because to me, it's a completely new word. It's crazy. Right, so we now have to use these cobblestone frame stairs, and we got the cobblestone frame pillar 50s. So this is going to be not too bad to place, I don't think, because we can go ahead and use... Okay, let's start from this side then, considering that I've got that. So we can do this, and then we can pretty much just place one on each one, and then come out, and then place another one. I think that's going to be the best way we can work with this, rather than trying to alternate between them, which is fine. So let me go ahead and do that. So there's those ones. So we shouldn't need too many of these. Once we got these ones in as well, it'll be easier to put the pillar ones in. Because they can just sit between them, and then putting the rest of them in is going to be nice and easy too. I haven't made the arrow slits yet. I'm going to do the arrow slits at the end, but that should do for that side. Let's go around the other side and repeat. So it's a lot of rinsing and repeating doing this, but you know, it's fun. It's quite relaxing considering we've had a couple of looting and zombie killing episodes, so I think it'll be quite fun just to kick back a little bit, do some more building, make our base better. So let's try not to fall. That would be useful. Okay, if I'm very careful, which I'm gonna fall and sprain my leg. I can see it now, but you know, solid. I was never the best at platform games. Okay, when we're at the Happy Balloon Blacksmith area though, then we're kind of safe. Whoa! I nearly fell then. Right, here we go. This side isn't dangerous. This is the practice side. This is like the training wheels. If I fall here, you know, it's fine. It's the other side I got to watch out for. Right, okay, so we need to go this side. Right, let's go block one there. Yeah, so putting these down is going to be the more time-consuming bit. But the good thing is, though, we now have a nail gun so that I can upgrade these nice and easy. Here we go. Okay. Now, I am in the debug mode, just so you guys know, and that is because if the structural integrity does go weird on this thing, there is a button that says in the debugs mode that says to recalculate it, so I'm not going to use debug for any creative purposes. It's literally just if the structural integrity is not what it should be, which it has been doing recently, then I can pretty much just remedy that on the fly, so I don't have to worry about it so much. Physics is still on, so structural integrity, you know, is still on and still the same as it ever was, but yeah, there's a difference. Ah, there's the block I wanted to take out as well. Go away, wood block. You're not welcome here. Right, so actually, let's build. Oh, I need to take these out too. All right, come on, a newt. Out you go. And that one. Do I have any around this side? Yeah, here we go. Let's get rid of them. There we go. Just knock those down. Cool. Let's try this again. Now the good thing is I've got the mining helmet now, so it's nice and bright up here. The flagstone is pretty reflective though, for the light. So if it's a little bit too bright, we might be able to turn it off. But I think it'll be fine. It's actually okay. My gamma is at 100%. Usually I have it at 75 when I've not got a mining helmet. Oh, that was lucky. Save myself there. Usually I've got it at like 75, which is what it is by default. So maybe that's it. But remember, I'm still at alpha 15.0. I've not updated to 0.1. Right, here we go. Oh, man. I'm glad that we're doing the inside first. Because if I fall onto my own spikes, then I've got, I'm going to be in trouble if that happens. Right, so that's that side done. So let's go and do this side. So yeah, placing these is the hard bit. And then once we've done that, then we're plain sailing. Right, here we go. Huh. Don't fall off. Oh, don't fall off. Oh, God. Okay, it's really difficult not to fall off of these because it's like it's kind of hard to see where the platform is when you're in first person. Like I'm okay platforming in third person because you can kind of line up yourself a little bit, but in first person it's actually very difficult, especially for me. The good thing though is if I misplace a frame, I can just take it back, which is brilliant. That works for me. There we go, and you. Okay. Oh, okay. We did that side right. What side's next? Right, that side, which we've done, and we've done that side. So it was only the other side on the outer area that we needed to do, wasn't it? Yeah. So let's go ahead and do this side. So once again, dicing with death right here. There's the cold hard stone below me. So let's go ahead and chuck all these on. There we go. Ooh. There we go. Be careful. Oh, there we go. Oh man, this is quite fun though. It's like platform madness. It's brilliant. See, you can 7 Days to Die is a true sandbox game because you can do platforming, you can do anything you want. It's brilliant. Right, so we did them on the inside, didn't we? Yeah. So it's only this bit to go now. So I think this is the last outer side that I have to do, thankfully, which is a good thing. Now, at least, though, there is a bar there to save me if I fall. I can try and land on the bar if I, you know, fall down and then get in the window. So we should be okay. Oh, man. I might actually do this. I'm going to be so pleased with myself if I actually do this and not fall. Because, you know, I do so many things that can break my leg. And I know Happy Balloon is doing the how many times Max broke his leg counter. I think, dude, I know you said you weren't going to count sprains, but I think you should as well. Just count sprains. Right, that's that bit done, and then we just got the inside to go. And then once we've done that, then we can start putting the pillar ones on, and then we can upgrade the first layer and see how it looks on the inside. I'm just keeping an eye out for, I think today is dog day as well, because you've got, it resets on day 54, so it's one day behind again. So yeah, I think dog day is now a few days behind. So just might have to be careful for wandering dog hordes and things. Should be alright though. But yeah, I think it's dog day today. I'm not exactly sure because I know it switches, but I'm not exactly sure when it is. I made a post on Facebook to a 7 Days to Die group about it, and I listed all the days there. But I had to go and remind myself on when they are, because yeah, it's not every fifth day anymore. It kind of goes fifth, and then like fourth, and it's really, really odd. All right. There we go. So now I've done that, we can now go ahead and plonk in These ones, okay, so it wants us to go this side first. Okay, that's fine. So now we can just chuck these in here. So get these bits in here. And this is the bit that's going to stop me from falling off. Because, you know, that would be bad. Well, it'd be funny for you guys, but it'd be bad for me. So, yeah, I want to not fall off. That would be lovely. Now, I'm not sure what to do with this bit, though. I think I'll come back to that bit. I'm not sure what to do there at the entrance part. So we'll have a look into that in a little while. So let's just go and put those in. Now, one thing I do need to make, I just remembered, is the actual cobblestone arrow slits as well. I haven't made those yet, so let's go over this side and do the same. So I just say it's just a good thing that cops don't come as part of regular wandering hordes, because they'll just puke on this and knock it down. That'd be quite funny, actually. All this work that I'm doing, like, you know, risking my life on platforms and all that stuff to make this, and then the cop just goes bleh, and just pukes it down. That'd be hilarious. I can't believe, though, how many cops we came across in the Hub City in the last episode. Like, we had, like, up to three, even four at once in some cases. Like, up at the start, the city was just, like, empty. There was no one there. And then as soon as we came back and did some more looting, they all just appeared. It was crazy. It was brilliant, though. Right, here we go. So, chuck you in. All right. So recently as well, I've been checking out Games for Kicks' channel. Not necessarily 7 Days to Die Let's Play. I do watch those occasionally. I see he does. I think he still does Classic Horde Survival. I think he's quite a fan of that one, and I quite like the look of that. So maybe we could do some kind of modded soon. I know SDX is now released for A15, though. That came out on Christmas Day, which is awesome. But anyway, back to the point. I saw that he started playing a game called Raft, and essentially what it is it's like a survival game where you start on like a little wooden 2x2 raft, and there's a shark that tries to eat you. So you're in the water, but like the resources kind of float across the water to you and things like that. So you've got to like get in the resources yourself. You have like a grappling hook of sorts, or like a hook, and you have to hook in the resources and then use those to then expand your raft. And if the shark can't get you, he'll try and attack the raft. It's quite an interesting concept for a game. And I don't know whether you guys would like me to have a go at that, or if that would be something you'd be interested in, because I know we do a lot of 7 Days. I am planning a Minecraft series at some point, by the way, just so you guys know. Probably when I've finished A14 modded and this one, so then I can have Minecraft and A15 modded going together. Because I think that'd be something that you guys would like to see. Because I've heard a few of you say that you'd like to see some Minecraft. So I would be doing that as well. But that's going to be cool. So there we go. That is done, all this bit here. So now the last bits to do are, of course, these. But I think to be on the safe side, we're going to upgrade these first. Now, the good thing is, I have a nail gun to do that, which is perfect. So we can literally just go ahead and upgrade these nice and quickly. So it's not the quickest in the world, but it's better than nothing. So better than the hammer by a long way. So yeah, that's looking okay. So yeah, that will stop us falling off, which is the main point. And I don't believe spiders will be able to get through that either, because that occupies more than... I think they need like 2/3 of a block or so to be able to get in. And that is definitely more than that. So I think what I'll do is I'll do the inside first. Oh, and I can just walk with them like that. Look at that. There we go. And, okay. We'll do the inside first and then work our way out. That should do. So, yeah. Just wondering if you'd like me to play Raft as well. It's a game that I can... Essentially, the game, you can put as much money or as little money into it as you want. So, it's a game that, obviously, I'm going to pay for. Because, you know, I know game development is hard. So, if I'm going to play it, I'm going to give the game devs, you know, what I would expect to play for an in-dev game, which is probably like, you know, between £8 and £10. So I think that sounds fair enough. So if it's something you'd like to see on the channel, then, you know, let me know if you'd like to see it. I mean, check out Games for Kicks as one, because, you know, he does a good job of explaining how it all works. And, you know, I think it's quite a fun looking game. It's not very developed yet. There's still like a load of stuff that I think they need to add. I think it's quite early access, but it looks good. It's definitely interesting and it's worth noting. So yeah, I'm all up for doing like new games, and you know, I like supporting independent game devs and things like that. So if there's more I can do towards that, then obviously amazing. I know like that kind of goes against that with Minecraft being like probably the most popular game in the world. Well, maybe apart from Super Mario and Pokemon, but still. Minecraft is pretty up there. Right, so, oh, it's now nighttime as well. It's now nighttime! Excellent! I probably need to go and get my cobblestone out of the workbench in a minute so we can continue crafting it. Because that's the good thing, I can craft stuff in the workbench and I can craft stuff in my inventory right here as well, which is much better. But yeah, these are going to look, I think these are going to look very good once we're done. We'll have to have a look from the outside. Now, the reason I'm making them on the inside as well is so that I can go ahead and, you know, shoot down from the inside as well. Because, you know, if you're in a castle and someone breaks in from your walls, you'll want to be able to shoot them on the inside as well. I know it's not so important here, but say if a spider managed to get up to that bit, which they probably would if they broke in, then, you know, we've got that. So there is one side done. So that's one. Now we just got to do the other side, so let's go ahead and upgrade all these. There we go. So yeah, I'm still, at the current time, I'm still waiting for Pounty Love's next challenge. I know she said it'd be fun to try blowing zombies up with cars or something, which I think would be quite fun, but I don't know how doable it is considering that, you know, there's not too many cars around. Especially in, like, towns I've already been to. I might have to go to, like, a fresh town to do it or something. And I don't know how I would blow up those cars without rockets as well. Because, you know, cars don't blow up very easily. You need to shoot them a few times to actually blow them up. So I don't know how viable or entertaining it would be for you guys. But, you know, I'm up for trying it. I mean, I might be able to try it in a creative world and just see exactly what it's like. I could always put some additional cars in the area as well. Right, there we go, that's that bit. So we're halfway there. Well, nearly halfway there. Well, we're over halfway there in the grand scheme of things, so I mean around this layer. I need to learn how to explain things better. Because I suck at that sometimes. I'm just like, yes, I'm halfway. No, wait, I'm actually three quarters of the way now at this technical point. But if you're talking about the side that I'm on at this current time, yeah, I need to be a bit more specific. It comes from being a mathematician, though, so, you know, I did do a degree in maths, and, you know, precision is what I do quite well, I think. Well, considering that I'm a blind bugger, you know, precision is something that I actually do well, which is ironic. Let's face it, that is ironic, but, you know, it works. It works! Here we go. So nearly done with this side, and we should have enough cobblestone to go all the way around, because I did make like 12,000 of it, so, you know, there's plenty of it, and then we can repair other stuff as well. I think I damaged some. I know I damaged some along here, I just want to go and check. Because, yeah, I swear I did hit one out by accident, and I thought, I'll just repair that later. And then, like a plank, I never kept note of what tower it was on. Oh well, we're nearly done with this bit anyway. So let's go ahead and do that. And then in a minute we'll just test it and see what the angle is that we can look at. But I think using the pillars is quite good, because then it will allow us to get a bit more of an angle when we're ducked down. So then it's gonna be like a multi-purpose thing. We'll have the arrow slits, and then we'll have other stuff as well. There we go. There we go, and a few more to go, and we'll be done. So the good thing with cobblestone is it will protect me from cops too, so that's always nice. There we go, so that's been done. So I might have to also take that bit out in the tower there. I'll think about how we're going to do that in a minute. Right, let's head down to the Happy Balloon Blacksmith again. We can just drop in. There we go, we can just drop in here. Cool. Right, now I need to make arrow slits, I think is the next thing I need. So, do I have any more? I have some more cobble in there, actually. I'll take those. So, arrow slits is what I need now. I don't know how many we're going to need, but I can probably work it out in a minute. Let me go ahead and grab some wood out of here. So I did go and harvest a lot of wood. I've nearly used it all because of, just doing stuff. Right. Scrab all that out so we can craft the remainder. There we go. So we've got more stuff crafting up now. Right, so arrow slits. Let's see how many things are across the top. So the arrow slits are going to go between the stairs. So there's four there. So that's going to be, that's eight. So that's 16 in total. Then there's one, two, three, four. Hang on. So we've got 16 so far. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So that's 14, 28. Plus another 28, that's 56 on that side. So that's 16 and 56, which is... I say maths and I can't bloody add up. Right, so that's 72. And then we've got... How many have we got this side? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 that side, so plus 28. Oh, I think that might actually be around 100. Yeah, that is a nice round figure of 100. So let's make some cobblestone arrow slits, which you have to make directly. So I think it's 100. Let's try it. Now, these are going to take some time to make. So what I can do in the meantime is, while I'm doing that, I can then go ahead and put these ones on the top. So let's head back inside the Happy Balloon Blacksmith. Don't worry, we will be building more stuff in the castle soon. Now, I've had another idea about these windows. I might consider using bars in the, maybe not in these ones, but in the ones above them. These ones I think I am going to take out because they kind of seem useless. You can't really get a good angle through them. So I think we're gonna end up taking those out. Let's have a... Because bars could ideally trap spiders. And we'll have those on the inside windows, which I think will look quite nice. So, we're going to have two cobblestone things each on these. So they should... let me turn this on again. Night vision sucks! I still need to take off those goggles. So we should be able to plonk down ones like this. There you go. That's nice and easy. That's looking good. And then let's go ahead and do it this side, and then we can work our way around. Look at that. So we're getting there. We're getting there. It might not look good when it's too high, but, you know, we can try it. We can always make the arrow slits higher as well, but that will reduce our visibility somewhat. So we want to try and make it so we can stay... We want it so that we can still see the zombies when they're coming from a distance. But that's kind of the point of the towers as well. We might even make the towers higher just to be able to do that. Or we could build a watchtower on the inside of the castle, which, again, is probably a better idea. Right, let's have a quick build here. There we go. So those... Oh, no, you come back. That's the good thing with these frames, is you can just pick them back up. So... When I F something up, which I usually do, we can just take him up, which is great. There we go. So I'm trying to build it as fast as we can so we can get as much done in this episode as we can. Because I do want to consider what we're going to do with the tower as well. I haven't actually taken anything out in the tower yet because I really don't know what the hell I'm going to do with it. But I do want to, like, you know, consider it with you guys and we'll see what the best approach is. Because obviously building it on the diagonals is not easy. We're going to have to remove the spikes as well. Right, so, you, there we go. So five in there. So yeah, we'll definitely have to make these ones higher, I think, but then, like, getting the angle on the arrow slits might not be so easy. We'll see, because it's all going to be pushed out by one, but when you go diagonally with that, it kind of goes a bit weird. I think I might be able to make it work. We'll see when we get to it, but I think it will be possible to make work. Just have to experiment a bit, and that's half the fun. Experimenting is very fun with this game. I like it. So, let's do you. Oh, come here. There you go. Awesome. There we go. That's looking good. So you guys and you guys. There we go. So we can place them all up here like that. Getting this done nice and quickly as well. It's probably what you guys like to see, that we're doing it quickly. I mean, I could speed this up, but I like taking the opportunity to, you know, have a bit more of a relaxed session with you guys and, you know, kind of chat to you a little bit about things. So it's quite nice doing that. Right. Now, though, we should have the arrow slits. They should be all done now, I would have thought. They've done. We got 75 done, so we can start laying them down. So we're going to lay the arrow slits pretty much directly on top of these things. Now, the structural integrity should hold this. I say should. No, my luck, it probably won't, but, you know. Things happen. Right, there you go. That's those ones. Right, let's do the outside first, then we'll do the inside. Then we can see how this looks once we've upgraded it. Because I think together with the actual castle, it might make the towers just look really naff. But you know, we're gonna remodel those anyway, so it's no big concern of mine, to be honest. Alright, so that's that bit done. And we're already in the side. Yay! Right, let's go. Oh, I forgot to I've got to place one right there. Let me go and remedy that. Right, come here, you. There we go. Right, so one is there. And let's go. So those. And the good thing is, we can still kind of walk along this bit as well. So I think it's going to be pretty cool once it's done. Now, the one thing I would like to have is the flagstone wedges, because I think if we had the wedges, we wouldn't need these bits, and we could stand against the arrow slits just fine, which would give us more visibility. But you can't build the wedge ones with flagstone, unfortunately. You can. There is another block called a flagstone gable, but you also can't build those. You have to... At least I don't think you can. I think you just have to get those from creative, so... Yeah, more flagstone shapes would be nice for castles. So, Fun Pimps, if you're listening, add some more flagstone variety. I think, though, that might be a thing in A16 anyway, because of the universal texturing system. So, the cool thing is, though, in A16, right, we could build a castle out of steel, but then paint it to look like flagstone, which is brilliant. So, we can have all the defensive capabilities of a higher-grade material, but it still looks castle-y. And that's something I'm looking forward to doing as well. We can actually make a nice-looking house of sorts and decorate it the way we want, which is going to be really nice. Because currently, we can't really do that in the current version of the game. You can a little bit if you decorate it well. I mean, I've seen some very good builds. Mine not included, obviously. My builds are crap in terms of decoration, but I've seen some very good builds that are decorated as well as functional. And I am trying to become better at decorating things. Because I know it's not really important, but, you know, still want a nice place to live in. And, you know, it is a survival type game. You know, you want to thrive as well as just survive, right? That's the whole objective with these kind of things. You have to, you know, start thriving, and then you know you're at a good point in the game. Right, I have misplaced one, so let's just pickaxe that out. God damn it! That means we're gonna have to make another one. And I think I might have calculated this right. I think, hang on, 1, 2, 3, 4. I think I did actually calculate that correctly. Oh my god, I actually did maths. That is crazy. Right, what do we got here? There we go, 2, 3, 4. I think that's all of them. Yeah, so now all we have to do is go ahead and upgrade these things. So this will take a little bit of time. But no longer than it would have taken to do the whole outside bit. And then we should have some nice looking walls once we're done with this. I think this is going to look quite nice. So yeah, then we'll have to figure out what we're going to do with the towers as well. So what I'm going to do, let me quickly jump off camera and do these upgrades. And then we'll take a look at it and see what it's like. So I'll be back in just a sec. Alrighty, we have now done the top. And look at that. Look at that. That looks pretty cool, in my opinion. That looks very architectural. I like it. I like it. I think that looks really cool. So having like the stairs kind of adds to the architecturalness of the whole thing. And I think that looks really nice. So now we actually have an area to stand above the zombies and shoot down from both sides of the wall, which is amazing. So that, in terms of that, we are now sorted in that regard. That is done. So there we go. We now have some stand and shoot areas. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the creative world again, and we're going to grab the tower. So I'm just going to kind of remake part of the tower. I won't make it like full height. I'll probably make a quarter of it so we can try out the block designs on that. And then once I'm in there, we'll go back and then we'll see how we can make that better as well. So I'll see you in just a bit. Alrighty, so back in the creative world again. This is a kind of smaller version of the tower that we've got. So I've only made a quarter of the tower, and I've obviously not included the log at that point in the tower either. So we're going to have to work out what to do with this thing to make it better. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is we're going to replace these ones again with the other blocks from the cobblestone blocks. So we're going to have the flagstone ramps there. Like this. So I have a flagstone ramp there, and we'll have a flagstone ramp in this one as well. So that's gonna take that bit into account there, and then we need to expand out that bit with the cobblestone. I guess I'll just make it out of flagstone for now, so I can you know, take things down as I need to. So we're gonna go ahead and chop that bit off. At least I think this is how it looks. I think the arrow slits are there, so I think that's how we're gonna do it. So these arrow slits also need to move one forward. So let me go and chop these off as well, and let's see how we can actually get this thing to work. So let's get the flagstone version of the stairs, just so we can do that and make it a little bit easier on ourselves. So we're gonna have one set of stairs there, and one set of stairs there, and then the old design was that we'd have one, two. And we'd also have one and two, like that. Now, the problem comes, as you'll see in just a sec, when we've got the pillar in, like, if it wants to go the right way, fine, I'll put you in first then. We'll put one in there, and one in there, and then we'll get those arrow slits back in again as well. So let me, so the arrow slits now go here, and they go here. Come on, there we go. So now the problem comes is what the hell do we do with this bit around the side? Now, one thing I'm thinking we could do is kind of make a similar-ish design. So we could take this bit out here. So we're gonna have to, I think we're gonna have to do something along these lines. We're gonna have to take that bit out there, then we're gonna have a we're gonna have a full flagstone block here and here. And then we're going to need, the corner of the tower needs to go there, but we're going to have to do this in such a way that it works. And I'm not sure exactly how this is going to work. But let's try something. Let's go, because we can't have diagonal corner stairs or anything like that. It's not that fancy yet, so we can't unfortunately do that kind of rotation with the blocks. But we can, what we can do is that, and then we can have, of course, that there. And that there. So that's what we're going to have to do with that bit. And now we have the log that comes here. So we're going to have to take out where the log spike is and replace that with a block of flagstone there, I think. I think what we're going to have to do is end up just squaring out the entire tower. And I don't know how good that's going to look, in all honesty. It might look okay. Let's try it. Let's see if it works before we judge it. Let's see if it works first. So what we're going to need is the we're not going to need this time though the flagstone. We're not going to need these things this time though, because when the zombies are down here, they're going to get right under the wall, and we need to see down there to be able to shoot them. So maybe what we need to do is something a little bit different. So why don't we try? If I put this down here, can I fall through it? No. Okay, so that's going to allow me to still shoot down on that bit right there. Okay, so doing this is a start. That's gonna be the start of it, so we can at least shoot down there. Now, something else I want to check. If I take this one out and replace it with... So we still need to kind of see what's there as well. So we could do something like... this. It doesn't look great, but hang on. Let me test something really quick. If I do that, can I fall down there? Yes. Okay, so we can't do that. And I sprained my leg. Nice. There you go. Knew it'd happen. Right, so there you go. Happy blue one for the counter for you. So maybe then what we're going to have to do is we'll have to do it like this, because I know that I can't fall through those bits, so that's that bit sorted. You know, we don't need to worry about that bit now. We can't have the arrow slits diagonally either, so the closest we can get to like a diagonal arrow slit is probably, well, in actual fact, that's the If we come here, how much of the wall can I see? Because it doesn't look good. That does not look good. That looks pretty terrible, to be fair. The only other thing I can think of is if we actually make this tower, if we remove that log and then make that tower higher. So the only other thing I can think of that's going to make this better is to stop the zombies getting there entirely. Because there will be a log here, thinking about it. So if I can get the rotation around the right way. So we could remove those, and then that bit is no longer a worry. And then we can literally stick with the other one. But I want to have a way so that I don't fall out of that. But where it's diagonal, it's not so easy to do that whilst letting it look good. Which is a problem. Let's have a look and see what other types of cobblestone blocks there are. Because I know there's a lot of different types of cobblestone blocks that we could potentially use. So we've got the pillars and the poles. Now the poles I know you can fall through. Which is another matter entirely. But we do have cobblestone wedges. And we have wedge tips as well. Which again might just be a bit weird looking. But we can try it. We can try it, right, as long as it can go the direction I need it to, because we've had some issues with wedges and wedge tips. So, yeah, there might be issues with that. So what I need to do is have... Maybe we could have a wedge there, which is going to be in line with that. So we can add some, like, stairs and stuff there and have an arrow slit above that one. Then we can have a wedge there, and then there's going to be... There's going to need to be something in the middle to stop me falling. So whether that's going to be a flagstone thing, I think I'm going to easily fall through that. That seems way too easy for me to fall through myself. Because, if I come here, I just slide out and fall straight down. And that's not what I want. But, you know, it looks okay. It looks okay. We can have something... Oh, this is such a hard one to do, because I need to have the diagonal bit out one as well. So what we're going to need to have, if I kind of build it how I think it needs to look, and then I can work from there with it. So let me come into flight mode again, so I can actually get up here. Because this is part of the hard bit, is just planning the whole thing and seeing how it's going to work as intended. Because what I should need then is, if I can get this, maybe have a pole there and a pole there, then I could... The thing is, I need to see the wall, and that pole, I know for a fact, is not going to allow me to see it, which again is another problem. But if I have the ramps there, how's the ramps pointing inwards? Maybe. Oh man, this is such a hard decision to do. Right, let's get rid of that cobblestone stuff and see if I can get this to work. So these ones aren't the answer. That's just going to make things... that's just going to make everything worse. So, not that. Not you. And this is going to fall down as soon as I destroy this thing, isn't it? So, we can let it fall, though. Bye-bye. So, yeah, that's the issue. Just trying to see where the zombies are from that point. Now, this other bit, though, is going to be okay. So what we can do is expand this. So the arrow slit will go here. Then we'll have an arrow slit, like, here. And then I think what we're going to need to do is have some diagonal ones. If I can not drop them, that would be lovely. There we go. Give me that. So we need some diagonal ones. That's going to kind of follow the contour of the tower a little bit. So we need to go... Oh, that was the right way. So we need one there and one there. I don't know how well this is going to hold it. I think this is going to fall. Okay, that just holds it. Okay, so we've got that bit done there. That's fine. And now we need to just work out how to connect the thing up. So these arrow slits are going to have to go. Yeah, I knew I'd have trouble with the corners. It's the hardest bit to get right. So what we could do, we could kind of have a crude It can, it, we can be a little bit crude about it, I think, because we need to see in the corners, and it needs to be, you know, it needs to be defensive and support and supported. So what we need to do then, I think we're going to have one there like this, and we're going to have. Hang on. Go the right way, you. Ah, there, one there like that, and then we'll just have a regular block in the middle, as we would do normally. Yeah, we'll just have. I think the only way we can do it really is to square it off like this. It doesn't look amazing, but I can see through there. And as far as I'm aware, I can't fall into that. Oh, yes, I can. Yes, I can. Okay. Scratch that then. That is not a good idea. Okay, I can fall. I didn't think I could, but it turns out if you're at just the right position, you do fall through. All right, so that would be problem number one. So take that out. Doesn't destroy it. Good. The other thing I could think of is just having a block there, but that'll look crap as well. You know what? We're just going to have to do that. We're going to have to do it. We're going to have to do it so it's like this, I think. Because that looks okay from the inside. I quite like the look of that. Let's just go and check from the outside how it looks. Yeah, I don't like that bit. I don't like that bit. That looks a bit... Yeah, it looks a bit pants, if I'm honest. The only other way I can think of... Because we can't get the corner stairs on the go. Right, let me make another model of this tower. And let me try it where these things are moved one over. Because that might solve it. So let me just do that and I'll be right back. Alright, I'm finally back. And I think I've figured out how we're going to do this. Unfortunately, it means that we have to get rid of most of the curvature of the castle towers. So we're not going to be able to build the towers like the curved variety anymore if we want this new design to work on them. But at the same time, let's have a look at both. So I've got this variety. So if we come down on here, and let me just hide my block. Let's just see what we can see when we're down here. So when we're down here and we duck, we can kind of see what's going on in the corner there, and we can see all the way down the wall as well. So it's not too bad. We can see the corner from here, so that's a positive sign. The fact that we can see the corner, not quite right in the corner, but that's a good thing. We have retreat over here as well, so you know we can always decide where we want to go with that. So we can see most of the stuff down there when we're looking through trying to shoot the zombies. So that's a good one. Now the other one I did was of course where I moved it all one over. So you can essentially see I've had to keep the corner one the same. But I've now swapped out the blocks. Now these are a mix of flag and cobble, but they'll be sorted soon. And then I've used one of those corner ones over here. So then I can come down here, and then I can very clearly see what's down there. Unfortunately, that looks kind of crap because you know that looks like it's you know not being supported by anything, which it isn't really, and that's not really the greatest looking thing right there. But there is that option as well. The other thing we could do is just place a flat block there and have it so that we have to kind of, you know, get between these two things and a flat block, which could also work as well. But I kind of like being able to get down a little bit closer to them and looking down there. The other issue is we can't actually see the corner as well, and we actually have to come back here to see the corner. So I think what we're going to use is we're going to use this one, because in my mind it looks slightly better, and we can see pretty much just as much of the corner as we can from the other side. And this one actually looks like it's being a bit more supported. We don't have the fancy stairs on that bit, but I could probably swap those in on those blocks right there. So I think this is the one we're going to go for. Unfortunately, it means that we're going to have to remodel all of the towers, and there's a lot of remodeling to be done to get that to work. So essentially what I've got to do is I've got to take out all the blocks in the tower and replace it with these. So I'm gonna head into my world and do that, and then when we're ready to build the top of the towers, I'll be right back. Alrighty guys, I'm back. I've only done one of the towers because this took me a long time to actually get the tower looking the way I wanted it to. I had to remove so much, and what I've decided to do is I'm gonna keep the wood bits down there. Hang on, I don't know if I can show you quite so accurately without falling off. Oh no, I can't! Hold it! Hold it! Hold it! Oh dear, let me out the spikes. Oh god, that went horribly wrong. That went horribly wrong. Ow. 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 I didn't break my leg though. I didn't break my leg! How is that possible? That is amazing. Right, let me out of here. Ow. But right, that's what I've decided to do. So the tower has now been squared off a little bit, as you can see. But I think that's the best that I'm going to be able to get it. But, you know, I think that looks, in a way, I think that looks a bit better. Like, with these new things here, I think that actually suits it better than that one. I like the round towers, but I think the square towers look okay. Anyway, let's get back up there and not fall. I was trying to demonstrate to you guys what I'd done, but then, of course, the inevitable happened and I fell off. See, I knew I was going to fall off it eventually. But yeah, it was a long-winded process to get these towers upgraded so to what they are now. And we're still going to have to do the top. But what I want to do is I want to do the top with you guys just so we can see how it's going to look. So let's have a look at and see how this is going to work. So let's go ahead and place down. First of all, we'll do these ones. So these are the blocks that are going to go down in here like that. And then we're going to rotate them. And let's do... So there's not as many to put down here, but we're going to need to make some more cobblestone arrow slits in a minute so we can use those. And, of course, the rotation is off. So let me go that way. Oh, fine. I'll do it your way then. Oh. Ah! There we go. Right. Yeah, I'm looking forward to the new rotations in A16 as well, because that should help resolve a lot of things. Right, so, yeah, this wood stuff here, though, I think I might have to take that out as well, just because that's where the stairs are going to go for the cobblestone, but... I'll do that in a bit. I'm just going to take these top ones out for now. Right, so here's the cobblestone frame stairs. So we're going to dot these around the top first. So, okay, that's pointing upside down this way. So some of these we can kind of... I guess some of them we don't actually have to use the stairs because they're already, you know, full cobblestone blocks. I mean, that one we'd have to, like there. But those two we wouldn't have to. We'd have to do one... Need to see one there and one there, but on that one there, I could use the full cobblestone block there and there. That actually works out quite nicely with how those have gone. So I'm going to have to do the same around that side as well. So let me jump up here again. Go on, let me up you. Right, so we're going to have one there and one there. There we go. So that's that bit in. So let's get these and then the rest are going to be stairs, of course. So stairs. Okay, we're going this way then. Let's try and do this without falling to our demise. This is not easy. Once you've got the first one in there, then it's all right, because you can then come around here and kind of jump to them, so it's okay. Actually, that's the point. The wood is there, so we can use that as our initial one. Why did I not think of that before? Use the wood. Use what's there, Max, you idiot. Right. You idiot. Right, let's go there. Right, there we go. Now I can put these in. Because I want to do one tower just to see how it looks. I think it's going to look fine. It might... I know we had it looking nice and rounded and things like that. And it was, you know, it was a bit less blocky than most of the things I'd done. But, you know, in all honesty, where we've not got enough block shapes, it can't be, you know, you can't do too much with it once you've done that to make it, you know, look any decent, if you know what I mean. So... Right, so we're going to have that there, and that there, and then we've got one in here. Now, I also had to move the farms down a bit as well, so you can see that I've had to take one square out of the farmland. That's just so the tower can go there. I might move the whole farm across, like, one layer at some point, but I'll get to that when I get to it. So let's go ahead and upgrade these first. And then we'll have to put the frame corners in just a sec. So I'm going to upgrade them first. Because I think it'll look okay. Like, square towers are a lot easier to maintain as well than the round ones. Plus, I've left the inside of the tower. You'll probably see I've left the inside exactly the same. So that should help. Here we go. And then we can go ahead and do these. Nice. Cool. So that's that bit done there. So next we need... What do we need now? We need those pillar ones, so we need these. So the pillar ones are now going to go around these bits as they did before. If I can get them the right way, there we go. So let's get those ones in here, and then we'll put four more that side. So each thing requires 16 arrow slits by the looks of things. which is nice and easy to remember, so I can go ahead and make those in a bit as well. So I'm going to need 64 arrow slits in total, so long as I put them down correctly. I'll probably need more. I'll make a few spare. Do you know what I'm like? There we go. So we got those, and let's go ahead and place down the full blocks. Oh, and I also made these cobblestone frame corners as well. So let me put those there for a second. Probably not the best idea, considering that it's probably going to... Wandering Horde's probably going to happen at some point. Right. So I need it to go upside down. There we go. So what ones it give me first? Okay, that one first. So hard to see these things sometimes. So we've got one there. Okay, yeah, it's going this way around. Cool. Nice clockwise direction then. So one there, one there. So this is going to be like the corner sections. One here. And one here. There we go. Let's get those in. Just upgrade all those while I'm thinking about it, and then we can put the rest in. And, oh, I could have just upgraded those other things though, right? Okay, let me just do these quick. The lengths I go to make a castle tower look nice and function well is... It's quite crazy though. It's very hard to get it to work, to be perfectly honest. It's very tricky. There we go. And then this one. Now the cool thing about this bit is here, if zombies like breach onto the walls, I've got a little bit to shoot them from as well. So it's not quite centered, but you know, it provides a way that if they manage to get up here for some reason, I can still shoot at them, which is great. So that's gonna help a lot. There we go, and let's go ahead and drop these in. Done. Right, now let's do the blocks, and I should make some arrow slits as well. How many can I make in total? 187. I don't need that many. I need 64 in total, so I'll get those crafting now. And let's go ahead and put the blocks on. So I'll do these ones first and upgrade them. And I'll put the rest on. But you can see a hell of a lot from this tower, though. It's really good. So I definitely want a watchtower, though, because that would be very cool. So let's have that. Haven't seen any zombies yet, so... I guess building isn't attracting any screamers or anything, which is a good thing. Not complaining about that whatsoever. Right, let's go and then do these. So, again, same kind of design as the other towers. Yeah, I think it's going to look better once we've got this in and all finished up. Then you'll see it might look better than what it has been right now. I know, like, you know, we've taken out the roundness of the tower, but at the same time, it's going to be a bit more functional and hopefully less zombies will be able to break into it. That's gonna be a very good thing. So there we go. Right, there we go. So now let's upgrade these ones while we're waiting for those arrow slits to do. So nice safe area over here. If they had like a diagonal kind of arrow slit as well, I'd so use those, but they don't have them, so I can't really make a rounded tower that functions as well as a square one. Because that's just the nature of voxels, you know, they are square, so. Oh, if only the chisel and bits mod were available for this, that would be amazing. For anyone who doesn't know, chisel and bits is a mod for Minecraft that pretty much lets you make a block any way you want by taking components of other blocks and then putting them together. So you can pretty much make, although it's still tiny cubes, but you can make a lot more intricate shapes and things with it, which is really cool. It's in the Direwolf 20 mod pack as well. And Direwolf is probably one of my favourite Minecraft players ever. He's pretty good. He knows a lot about like all the mods going, and the way he does his Let's Plays is kind of like a tutorial series. So it's pretty cool. Like if you're looking to get into modded Minecraft, watch Direwolf 20, because he makes everything really easy to understand. Plus he has his own mod pack as well, so you can always follow along with what he does. So let's go ahead and drop these in, and hopefully not misplace them. Okay, four out of 16. We're in the running for the championship right now. Oh, and the good thing is we can have some like other stuff up here as well. So we could do some like lamps up here or something like that, which I think will look quite nice. Right, so there's you. Right, let's come on. Can we do all 16 without misplacing one? That'd be amazing if we can. Oh, one more. Yeah. Yes, there we go. Right, so here's the top of the tower, and it looks pretty decent. Looks pretty cool. I quite like it. One thing I might do is add some ramps here that go like up there to kind of like make it look like it's being supported a bit more. But let's go downstairs and have a look and see what it's like from the outside, because it might look crap, but it might look okay at the same time. What I know is that this design works great on the walls. So the towers are also square objects, so now it's going to work great on the towers. But you can see that I've tried to keep the roundness of the towers on the inside. I'm not taking anything out here. In fact, I actually replaced a few blocks that I'd actually forgotten to put in the first time. So it actually helped me find some missing ones. But let's have a look and let's go this way. Wait, glitching. There we go. Just get in and duck. I'll sort it. Right, let's have a look. Yeah, I kind of like it. Like, I know the aristocrats look weird, but it's functional. It's functional. It works in conjunction with the wall. Let's have a look at the let's have a look in comparison. So we've got that versus that. This versus this. I think I like that one better. I know it's square, but I think that looks it actually does look a lot more castly. I know that's round and things, but now we got those. That looks a crap ton more castly, which I like. I think that's pretty awesome. So let's get a view from the corner, so you can have a look. Yeah, look at that. Now that's proper castly. It makes the tower look a lot taller as well. It's not actually that much taller, but it makes it look huge in comparison. And that is awesome. That looks like part of the main bloody keep. that's amazing. But yeah, we're gonna have to do that with the entrance as well. But I think, guys, unfortunately, we are at our time for this episode. Now, I'm probably not gonna be doing all the towers all together, because we do have like other stuff to do. I want to try and do some more looting and things like that as well. And yeah, I'm sure Pound Too Loud is gonna have a challenge for me at some point as well, or maybe one of you will. I know Samori had one to do it with inverted controls. And that's quite interesting. I'll have to see if it's actually, if all the controls are invertible. I think they should be, but that'll be quite interesting. But yeah, that's pretty much where we're at right now. So we've got the top of the walls done, and we got the towers done. So yeah, just need to do that bit there. Maybe I should make that one higher as well. But yeah, we need to do the entrance bit, which is pretty much in a square anyway. So that bit there should be fine. We'll just move it over one and pull it out some. That balcony there I might end up taking out, because it's kind of useless. You can't really do anything. I'll keep like a, unless you have like a lower set of parapets there as well. Because what I want to do is I want to have it so that we have two entrances. We have a garage door here and then a garage door here as well on the other side. So then in both cases, when the zombies are here, we can be shooting down at them from here, like have some murder holes up there, shoot them down there. And then when they break in this bit, you know, here's these murder holes, we can, you know, rain all hell down on them from here as well. So there's a lot of stuff that I want to do and get sorted. So plenty of stuff, plenty of ideas for the castle. So yeah, I think that's gonna be really, really cool once we've got that done. But yeah, that's the tower. And from the inside, that looks pretty impressive as well. The architecture isn't great, but it kind of looks like it's going round. If you catch it at the right angle, it kind of looks a bit circular-ish. But yeah, it's the best I can do with the block shapes I've got at the moment. Maybe I'll come up with a better design at some point. But I think, guys, that is it for this episode. So I hope you enjoyed this one, and I will see you in the next one. So until then, bye!